The US government is unable to hack iPhones that use an encryption standard they helped create. Oh, the irony. Hi, Hacksaws. Julian here for DNews. Way back in 2001, the National Institute of Standards and Technology announced their new standard for encryption technology. The Advanced Encryption Standard, or AES, was the product of years of testing competing designs with open public scrutiny and feedback. The winner was made by Belgian cryptographers Vincent Ryman and Joan Damon, who called it the Rain Doll cipher, and it's a doozy. The goal of cryptography is to make a message so scrambled the original message can't be divined. Rain Doll does this by taking the data and breaking it into 128-bit chunks, a bit being the smallest unit of data in a computer, either a 1 or a 0. It then substitutes these bits with other bits. It's not as simple as a 0 goes in and a 1 comes out. Changing any one of the input bits should cause an avalanche effect, changing about half the output bits. Once the bits are swapped, they're moved around in a process called permutation. The substitutions and permutations are repeated up to 14 times at the highest AES level, which makes analyzing the jumbled data for statistical fingerprints almost impossible. But you may be seeing a problem here. The AES was developed in plain view of everyone, so if you know the math behind the steps, you could just reverse any jumbling, right? Well, that's where the key comes in. In between each round of swapping and swirling, a key is added to the data to confound the information further. If you have that key and run the steps in reverse, you can decrypt the data almost instantly. The key itself is a set of bits, and they can be up to 256 bits long. If you don't have the key, that's 256 ones and zeros that you'd have to guess correctly to brute force your way in. And that would take over 10 to the 77 tries. That's one with 77 zeros after it. Security architect Mohit Arora estimates that would take 3 times 10 to the 56 years with a supercomputer, which, for our purposes, let's just call that forever. The AES is so successful, the government has been using it to encrypt top-secret documents since 2003. The knowledge that JFK was actually assassinated by the Roswell alien? It's probably guarded by this cipher. So it's not a big surprise that some companies, like Apple, use the AES too. Apple has implemented it on iPhones to encrypt your photos, texts, emails, and health info. But obviously you can't remember a 256-bit password, so that is actually burned into the hardware. It's a unique ID for each phone, and Apple claims they don't keep a record of the keys and no software can read it. When you set a passcode on your phone, it combines that with the key and your data is protected. So obviously, guessing the 4-digit PIN is much easier than the whole key because there are only 10,000 possibilities. Apple counters that with an 80 millisecond hardware delay and, crucially, a software delay too. If you put in the wrong PIN too many times, your phone will make you wait longer and longer before you can try again. Get it wrong 10 times and the phone will wipe its knowledge of the key and the data is lost forever if that setting is turned on. But here's the catch. If Apple were to create and sign an update that disables those delays and automatic wipe, and let you enter PIN attempts quickly through a computer, breaking into a device would be a dawdle. And that's exactly what the FBI is asking Apple to do. Right now, the FBI is attempting to unlock an iPhone 5C that belonged to a suspect in the San Bernardino terrorist attack. The FBI asked Apple to write an update that could only be applied to this particular device, but Apple CEO Tim Cook is worried that won't be the case. What if the firmware update leaks? It's digital, so even though the FBI wants it to only be usable for this particular phone, it's possible it could be changed and used for more. Newer iPhones have a piece of hardware called the Secure Enclave that would need a separate firmware update, but anything older than a 5S would be vulnerable to this skeleton key. If the FBI does end up getting their way, you can still protect yourself. Longer alphanumeric passcodes will take exponentially longer to crack because of the hardware delay. A 6-character passcode of letters and numbers could take over 5.5 years. Apple lets you use those instead of a 4-digit PIN for now. So just how powerful does producing a leading smartphone with tough security make Apple? Check out our sister show, Test Tube, here for the answer.
But much of Apple's financial success doesn't come from its quantity of sales, but rather the amount spent on each device. In fact, iPhones only count for roughly 14% of the global smartphone market.
Tim Cook's open letter talked about a need for discussion. Well, you know how the encryption works, you know what's at stake? Go on, discuss. There's the comments right down there, or you can find us on Twitter or Facebook. Subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on DNews.